bless you.
Yes. 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 Yes.
Abu ya kudarisen. Mungu awabariki.
Mungu akudarisen.
Amen.
Amen.
I appreciate.
Pana pano ndikutokoza kwambiri.
To be among you.
Kukala pakati pano.
Yeah, I was not even have a plan that today I will stand here.
Nari besonga kale ndongo soro kuti lero ine ndima pano.
But my elder forced me to come today.
Komba akuru anga ndavira chida monika kanise kuti anibere pano.
So I ask you a prayer.
Ndiye ndikupemba mapemphero anu.
Who is my poor English?
Ine ndi chizungu changa chochova choga ichi.
God bless you.
Mungu adaise.
Amen. Receive my greeting from my family and my church in Dar es Salaam there.
Landirani moni kuchokera kwa bajaranga kazi yanga komanso mpigo wanga kuchoka ku Dar es Salaam.
My name is Brother Kambarage Sankwa. My name is Brother Kambarage Sankwa Kambarage.
Jina langa ndine Kambarage Sankwa.
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 Yes, my origin
is in Mbeya.
But I'm living in Dar es
Salaam
for almost 20 years now.
Amen.
Amen. So I would like to invite all of you. Who sometimes we desire to come to Tanzania, especially Dar es Salaam.
Yes.
So, you just come. I will accommodate you.
Amen.
Even if you are going to stay here. Just come. Hallelujah. Yeah, so it is better to go there and there. You change mind. You change environment. You know the Bible in, I think it is in Philippians 2. I said, don't look your own thing, but also look what how others do.
Usamanga nile zango sokai, kumasuzia nganila za zango zimena kuchita.
So you just come.
Ndiye ni mzango bwera.
God bless you.
Mungu akubariki.
How many will come?
Nangara kuda tabwera.
Amen.
Amen. Yes. I will be happy to receive you.
Ah, itakala ugondo akukola dilani.
Amen.
Amen.
Are you happy?
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
So I don't know how to go through.
Yes, you know,
but I believe. Our Lord Jesus. Whom we are saving. Has got something. This morning for us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 So they allow me to read the Bible through my phone. Because it has got both English and Swahili. I just carry my Swahili Bible. And today I'm supposed to preach in English. So this is not a Bible. I don't prefer to use it in the pulpit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So you open your Bible.
In
Proverbs 2.
Chapter 2.
So the Proverbs 28, verse 13.
Miambo 28, verse 13.
So, before we read, I will ask my brother to pray.
Ibebe mbale wanga, abembele, tieni tibembele. Atate mzina, londa litzika, lambe watu Yesu Kristo. Tabaira mbuye mchipinda jino, tabaira inuwe mbuye mungu wa papu zonsi. Sigira ni malola na mbuye mungu wa papu zonsi, na kula ndimeo yatu. Inu ndinu mungu, amina mbuye mudati lenga, ndipo ndinu mungu, amini matitana, ndima uanu. Tabaira inu guna mbeso krisi tu. Kotero, tibuiga mbuye yatu pakuwa ila mbuye. Mushitenga ayo mbuye mungu wa papu zonsi. Baba pedopanga mbeso krisi tu, tijoge munu, dita tandizi ilo ndinu. Pukala tandizo latu ndinuwe ambuye. Wawe lingiru wa mawa ambiye ndizi luza kusukuru. Kuma tikupembe la mzimu anoyela. Umina ambiye so Kristi. Tunalimba mau amenewa. Utigire po mpama ambuye. Mvale ni mbale watu ambuye mungu wama uzonse. Wili sila nishito otu bilimene la ambuye. Kule melelo watina lanu. Ziko umo mungu wama uzonse. Vakuni inu magulisi sila nishito. Paso zonse ya kasiana. Kumpangangu watibuana kare wangwilo. Tilipana ambiye so Kristi. Kuyembeke sila kuta kwa inu. Chitani nilife, mutina meso kuchu pepera. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, my brother. God bless you.
Mungu akubariki.
Yes. So, Proverbs 28.
Ndiye mbo 28.
One verse.
Verse Mosiok.
13 verse.
Verse 13.
He who covers his sin will not prosper.
Wodi sama shimu wage sa taona mwai.
But whoever confesses and forsakes them will have mercy.
Oma wangu akumeleza na wasia atashindwa kifundo.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Can you read it together?
Uditinga ingerose mamosi.
Amen.
You can read in your language, I think. You can read it together. I want all of us to read it together.
Mufarabose dilinge pamosi a mujakulwe chatu chijewa. Wobi sama jimu wake sata unamwai. Kuma wangu wafundeleza na wasia atajiri wa jifundo.
Amen.
Amen.
Do you agree that?
Hanimu wafundeleza zimenezo?
Yes.
You may be seated.
Mota ukalabas.
Amen.
Amen.
It is a hard sermon.
Ndiyo unaligoni mba.
Amen.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
I don't know how I tremble myself because it cover both sides.
Inesiru kwa sewa unenika pangibani, ndi kujeje mela maine deka jifuma, aku kukuta mbali sons.
But we are here because we wanted to go to heaven. If the word of God come, and he wants to straight you, you just say amen, Lord.
Amen.
Amen. We have three things there.
Start to
number one,
choyamba.
Cover.
Upimba, ubisa.
Cover means height.
Upimba, yunadawza, ubisa.
Maybe I have this handkerchief, and then I put this, I covered.
Ndiye mwanga hapa nini ni kampa mwanga, agave nakaika muna pimba, George.
Hallelujah. Then number two, we have confesses.
Ndiye number two, tiindi kufodereza.
Means declare.
Bate kuti kulengeza.
Speak out.
Kujia mpura mwela.
Confess your sin.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Number three.
Chashi tatu.
Forsake.
Asiye ni.
Forgot.
Iwarani sasimenezu.
It means forgot.
Tata uza kuiwara.
Don't practice it anymore.
Sushi tanso mpango na pome hai.
Yes. Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, when we speak about sin, sin is a character. Hallelujah. It is a character. If you can read for me, Galatians 5,
verse 19 to 21.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You read my brother?
weringe verse 19 ndipo ntchito za tupi zionekera ndizo dama chodetsa kukuba zonyasa kupembedza mafano nyanga madano ndewo kaduka sopya ntima zotetana magawano mipatuko ujiru 21 kuletsera machimo mchezo ndi zina zote zimene ndikuchenjezani nazo monga ndachita kuti iwo akuchita chita zote sadza wa ufumu wa Mulungu.
Amen. Now the works of the flesh are evident,
ndiye ntchito za thupi zionekera,
which are
zimene ndi iyi
adultery,
adama dukololo,
fornication,
do adama,
uncleanness,
chidetso,
lewdness,
kukuba zonyasa,
idolatry,
kupembedza mafano,
sorcery,
nyanga,
hatred,
madano,
contention,
ndewo,
jealousies,
kanuka,
out of breath, out of lust,
zotetana,
selfish,
magawano,
sorry, selfish ambitions,
mipatuko,
deception,
njiru,
heresies,
kuletsera,
envy,
mchezo,
murders,
ndikupa,
the drunkenness,
kuletsera,
lewdness,
mchezo,
and the like of which I tell you,
ndizi na zote zimene ndikuchenjezani nazo
beforehand,
ndikuchenjezani nazo
just as I also told you in time past that those who practice such things will not inherit the kingdom of
God. Monga ndachita kuti monga ndachita kale kuti iwo akuchita zote sadzalowa ufumu wa Mulungu.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Those are our characters. Who believes
it?
Behind those characters, who is leading it, who is just leading it,
is
a demon. Do you believe that? So, let it lead somewhere. Brother Branham said,
Bale Branham kunena kuti,
character is a victor,
kalibe ndi chigonjetso,
not a gift.
Osati mphatso.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes, let it read from the message.
Ndiwelinge kunyokera mutenga.
An exposition of seven church ages.
Streaming
church age. Brother Branham would say, unless we suffer with him, we cannot reign with him. You have to suffer to reign.
Maina kuzuzika kuti inuwe mukala mulire.
The reason for this is that
chifukwa cha izvi ndiyakuti
the character simply is never made without suffering.
Kaidwe siri umbika wopanga kuvutikira.
Hallelujah. Character is a victory.
Kaidwe ndi chigonjetso,
not a gift.
Osati mphatso.
A man without character can't reign because the power apart from character is satanic.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when we read in Galatians, we find there is a lot of fruit of flesh. Those are characters.
Yes.
You see?
Yes.
So, to get out of bed, you need to fight.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And believe me, you can never get out of those characters for yourself. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You need the word of God. Like what I'm talking right now. You see? So when the word of God came to you and to say, at that time, is a sin. Fornication is a sin. Sorcery is a sin. And when you have that character, something came into your heart, started condemning you. And then, the Holy Spirit is there to help you. And then you say, Lord, if you help me to get out of this, I will never repeat to
this.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then, you start practicing against it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So you need to fight to get out of those characters. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes,
yes.
That's right.
And then you find out one of the day that thing have left him. You have no more fornicator.
Fruits.
Maybe out of I think it is 16. So the way you continue to hear the word of God, and the way you are fighting to go against it, and you are coming to the side of the Lord Jesus Christ.
And
the other day when you try to count, at that time, no more. Fornication, it is not disturbing no more. So where you get your victory. Hallelujah. So character is a victory, not a gift. So when you see somebody has good a character, he went through fighting against those bad characters. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes, brother. That's right.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So, there you start to pick. Is this character still following me? You find no. You have already won it. And the next? No, you have already won it.
And
the next? No, this one is. So I continue to fight. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I give you 2 days.
You must say in my will.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh yes.
God bless you. Till you find all of them, you are a conqueror. And then you are free.
Amen.
There's a place where you can worship God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why Paul said the fruit of flesh is always against the fruit of the spirit. And this always are fighting. So you can never get what you want. You see? If you can find out, you can count. You will find those fresh fruit. I think if I'm not mistaken, there are 16. And when you find out the fruit of spirit, it is only the 9. So when you can take one fruit of love,
amen,
that can treat all malice, envy, and what and what. Only that pill when you follow it.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Do you get me? When you go to Deuteronomy, I think 28. And when you account those blessings, you find there is a blessing a few in number. But when you come to the part of curse, you find it been maybe three times.
Yes, man.
Hallelujah. So, remember. Sorry, I didn't tell you the our subject. Hide not your sin. Hide not your
Musabise machimo ana.
As we let.
Wangati na wale.
Those who will cover their sin, they will never prosper.
Iyo amina mabisa machimo au sata pambana.
And those who will repent.
Iyo amina ama lapa.
And who will forsake it.
Amina ama wasia.
Mercy will be upon them. Mercy will be upon them.
Chifunde jitaka yaba iyo.
Hallelujah. So we want to talk about the dangers of hiding your sin. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Can we go now?
Yeah.
So, I want to read from the message. Amen.
Amen.
You know, when you commit a sin, when you commit a sin, devil will come to tell you this kind of sin. If you go to repent, you are going to kill your reputation. So just keep
going.
If you are going to confess your sin, you are going to get ashamed. So just keep it.
Yes.
Yes.
That is the devil. Try. How many sins in your life? You are still waiting to confess it. Maybe they were telling you one day it will be coming a good day that you are going to confess it. But how do you know? Will you be tomorrow? Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Let me tell you. You are not going to be ashamed. You are not going to kill your reputation. But it is the devil who are going to be ashamed. So when you repent and you are aligned with the word of God, it is the devil who is going to get ashamed. So an repented sin means that you make a friendship with demons. You make a friendship with the devil. Verse 8.
1 Timothy 5, verse 8.
Listen this carefully.
This is
but if anyone does not provide for his own. And especially for those in his household. He has denied the faith. Malachi 4. Say amen. He has denied the faith and is worse than a believer. Hallelujah. Can you swallow that, little brother?
What do you mean if you're bad and you got me in a minute?
So if you are not treating well your family,
Bible says
you are a senior unbeliever.
That's right. That's true.
This is the pastor in Zimbabwe. He was a good pastor. He was going there and there. Supporting many families. Paying school fees. Buying clothes. Doing many things for others. The day. So, people, there is a man who was reading his biography. This man of God, he did. So, he was a good man. He was a man of God. He was a nice brother. He was a nice pastor. How we need to go from his
friend?
That is an example.
Yes.
And his wife and the children were surprised.
Because you are the one who are madam.
Is this all attributes for our dad?
Could you say similar situations like number what time he does minutes?
We have been staying with the hunger.
If you are going to need a number,
oh, yes,
we have no closet. They supplied him the way he was supporting other families. But he's forgetting his own family. You see? And God will never accept that.
Yes.
Amen.
You remember in Peter? Peter said, if you treat bad your wife,
hallelujah,
yes, then your prayer will not go.
Yes.
And that is the word of God. You will try to your level best to get out of your problem. You ask the Lord to help your business, to help your problem, and God will say, go back. Repent to your wife. Make light with your life. Hallelujah. There was a sister there in Dar es
Salaam.
His husband.
Her husband.
He was working in a good company. Getting a lot of money. Then the brother has got no time with his wife. With family. Busy. And then the sister said, God, because this is your son. He's not getting time with my family. And even in the church. So please take that to a job. Same day, the brother was fired. Without a tangible reason. But a sister prayed there. After some time, he said, I was the one. And now we are together. Hallelujah. And she said, I'm going to play
again.
So that God can give you another job.
Amen.
When you will be late. Hallelujah. So don't never.
Yes.
Zona.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
That's true.
Treat your wife bad. You will never go anywhere.
Zona. Yes.
Maybe you are, brother, you are trying to find out what is the problem. First step. Go back. Search your relationship with your wife. Start there to make light. Not God. Start with your wife. From today. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And you sisters. When the brother will come. He said, please, my wife forgive me. I treated you bad. Hallelujah. You know, you may find sisters. Some sister, maybe he's too far. He went too far. There is no hope that a good relationship can be retained with his wife. But remember, God is a creator. He can recreate.
Yes.
He can recreate a good relationship. Just invite the
word.
Just invite the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
And then things will come back.
Yes.
And
he
will start prospering.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Amen.
So maybe even to you, sister, maybe you did something wrong to a brother.
Emma.
You go back.
Amen.
One month ago, or 2 months ago, I was preaching in the radio. There is a sister called me. He said, brother, do you have a time? I said, yes. And then he said, sorry, I need your help. I believed this message in Malachi 4. And then I backslid. I have got my husband. We have three children. But I find myself. The spirit of
Adatar.
So I was living with three men. Out of my husband. I went to Pentecostal church. And then I said to that pastor. But he didn't help me anything. And then something came into my heart. Why you left the message?
Yes.
And then something was telling her. That is unpardonable sin.
Yes.
And then she finds herself in a terrible condition. His weight was loose. And her husband was asking, are you sick? You become so
sleep.
And they told him, what can I do? I said, no. Because something is trying to call you. It means God is still loving you. But your wish is still alive. So go to your husband. Holy Ghost will be with you.
Yes.
Yes. So she was wondering if this husband will leave me. Where I'm
going.
And I told her, which is better? Husband to leave you?
Yeah.
Or Jesus to leave you?
Yes.
And then she take a step. She went to
Israel.
Said, I'm sorry. I did this and this and this. This is what was torturing me for all
this. Hallelujah.
Please forgive me. Dear husband, you know. When do you mean to repent? Holy Ghost will be there to help you.
Hallelujah.
And his husband, her husband, my wife. Till we get this condition. Why?
Question.
Why you tortured yourself like this? I forgive you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And his husband, her husband was Jerusalem. And then he said, you know, I want you also to join your church. I said, I want to talk with your husband. Give me my
number.
Then I phoned him. Brother, how are you? I'm fine. We have a convention in Dar es Salaam. Can you come? He said, I'm willing to come. But my financial status is not good.
This is the reason.
Are you ready to baptize? Yes, I am ready.
Yes.
Amen.
So I believe one of these days, he will come. I will baptize him. Hide not your sin. Hallelujah. Then the sister asked me another question. When I was at my village, I was living with my sister. Then she dropped 10,000.
10,000 shillings.
I grabbed it. I put it into my hand. But what can I do? The other day, I was living somewhere. Then the chicken of my neighbor came into my house. Then I closed the door. And then I ate the chicken. Many years ago. What can I do? Something.
Yes.
You know, Holy Ghost was talking to her to make things light. So if you are going to despise that voice, which is telling you go and repent, one of these days, that voice will get out. Then I told her. He said, now I have a trip to go to my village. You find 10,000. Then you find that sister. And then when you go there, tell him, now I'm Christian. I'm going to heaven. Many years ago, I was the one who took your 10,000. Here it is. Forgive me.
Yeah.
Yes.
And then he went to go to that the one who took his chicken. Tell her. I'm the one. I'm a Christian. I want to go to heaven. So tell me, should I give you a chicken or money? And whatever what is going to tell you, do it. After that, it will be over. Last week, she was giving me a report. Hallelujah. When I went to that sister who took with 10,000, she said, oh, sister, that is wonderful. I even will not take your 1,000. 10,000? I just forgive you. But you taught me something. Also, me, I did something wrong. To other people. I think I am supposed to go to make
right.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And then he went to that one who took the chicken. This is wonderful.
Oh,
I forgive you. And then,
dear son,
I went to other one. I didn't tell you. I went.
All
of them, they forgive me. I told, I said, sister, it is over. Just go. Ask the Lord to forgive
you.
Appreciate him for making a way for you to repent. Hallelujah. And then after that, it is the devil who is ashamed. Not a sister. Hallelujah. Are you okay?
God is in the way.
Amen. Hide not your sin.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. God bless you.
There's something hard here, but. Let's go.
Contact to it.
Yes. Because the word of God.
Hallelujah.
Yes. It's our blood. The blood will say, advise us that it with me, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. In Romans 2,
Romans chapter 2,
verse 4 and 6.
Verse 4 and 6.
I read.
Dwelling.
Or do you despise the riches of his goodness? Forbearance and long suffering, not knowing that goodness of God leads you to repentance. But in accordance with your hardness and your impotent heart, you are treasuring up of yourself wrath in the day of wrath and the liberation of righteous judgment of God.
Koma, koringa na ndugu matima wako, ndintima wako esa hapa, ulikutunji ya weka mkwiyo batuwa ya mkwiyo, ndila kufunduluta, kuweruza korunga mawakwanungu.
Who will render each one according to his deeds? Hallelujah.
Yeah.
You know, you can sometimes commit this
sin,
and God can hide you. You know, sometimes when you try to think, if maybe people did know what I committed, it's a real shame. But God always hide you. Always hide you. Always hide you. Always hide you. Hallelujah. And the Lord told us that long suffering of the Lord is leading you to repent. But because you refuse to repent, judgment will be upon you. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Let's start reading again. We'll come back to Romans.
Verse
1.
Aroma.
This one. Chapter 1, sorry.
Aroma chapter 1.
Starting. People, my brother and sister, I can see that you are now tired.
Bari aroma, ndugu na uri somo mwa roba tu.
So bear with me just a little.
Nde Mungu bila nani na pindi bangono.
Bible
says,
if you continue to hide your sin, to cover your sin, you will never prosper. Both spiritual, physical, financial, in a family matter. Hallelujah.
Amen. Yes.
God will come only to bless a family. to bless a business,
kudalitsa business yanu,
to bless anything,
kudalitsa chino chili chonse,
when it is green,
pamene chili choyera.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. In the message of God keeps his word.
Mutenga wabu masunga na wate.
Paragraph 208.
Nime 208.
Hallelujah. Amen. You are going to get wheat for it.
Inu mutenga puri na jifoya jimenecho.
Just remember that.
Tango humbugi na jimenecho.
Yes.
Inde.
Yes, indeed.
Inde zoena.
You will reap what you sow.
Mutabole na shimene numuna kara.
Yes, sir.
Inde bwana.
But.
Kona.
Whatever you do.
Kila niyo seme mujini.
Take your whipping here.
Tengani uchiwa mjana.
Get right up.
Kweza ni zose wimu.
Straighten up.
Ziruka, ziku, zirunga mitsen.
And say.
Nime mwenye.
Father.
Atate.
Here I am.
Bano inindiri bano.
Whip me just as the see.
Ni mwabule ni mwonga mene mwukule nila.
Sorry, whip me just as those feet.
Mwamu ni mwabule ni mwonga mene mwukule wana chini chwele nila.
Lord.
Amuye.
Here I am.
Inindiri bano.
That is right.
Mwujibon se.
Then you walk right back.
Ndiyeba asimwele ya ni.
With hallelujah.
Ni mwabita ki hallelujah.
On your heart.
Mwatina wano.
God let the wind down on you. Just say, yes, Lord. I deserve every bit of it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Just keep going. God will take you through. Alright.
Amen.
Amen.
Is that right?
God is surrender, guys.
So always be humble. When you commit anything, and
the
brother Brad told us that you are going to pay for it. You are going to pay a price. You see?
One.
You know, when King David. When he
finds
that he committed a sin, quickly he
kneeled
down without waiting.
And
Lord, forgive me. Forgive me for my
fault.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And God said, I love my servant David. So it depends. When you sin, when you commit a sin, when you do something evil, how you beat yourself quickly. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And Brother Branham said,
somewhere.
When you see that you commit a sin somewhere, don't wait. Hallelujah. You come back to Jesus and say, forgive me. I am sorry. They were just making some trap for me. I didn't mean to do
it.
And then, when God sees such a humble heart, he remove all your iniquities. And then you continue. But when you hear the devil,
say,
no, just wait for later. You will repent tomorrow. You repent the day after tomorrow. You know what will come? Then devil will make you to forget it.
Satana atabanga inu mwibare.
And you never know what is tormenting you.
Yesu msasiwa jiraji kukusu samwe wanu chani.
Because there is an unrepented sin somewhere.
Hallelujah.
So you need to be very careful every day.
When you call us samaritza, tibuli na ilose.
Every minute.
Amini tina ilose.
Every hour, every day, you come aligned with the word of God. Because the word told us,
Satana kutuza kuti
that the devil is upon you daily.
Kuti Satana alitenda malichake chilipali kutsiku nyasi.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we need to be cautious.
Ndeni maina dikarewe tsiwangino.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let me tell you something.
Nguzo lishina chake.
If you can take
ngati munga tenge
the statistic
achiwerengero.
How many do you know elephant?
Ndani akutsiwa ndovu.
Elephant is the big animal.
Ndovu ndi chinyama chachikuru kwambiri.
And then if you can find out maybe worldwide
mwina tsiwolosera basi
how many people has been killed with an elephant?
Ndiyankhangati amene aphedwa apo ndi chindovu.
You may find maybe 10 or 5.
Mutapeza mwina 10 kapena 5.
Worldwide.
Tsiwolosi.
And then you come to lion.
Ndiyo mufike ku mijango.
Lion is smaller.
Mkambo tu nyomanobosiana ndi njovu.
And when you take again the statistic
of
how many people has been killed with
ndiyanthu angati amene aphedwa
worldwide
dzikolose.
You may find maybe 200.
Ndiyo mutaweza kuti ni 200.
Hallelujah. Then you come down.
Ndiyo kena akamutsika pansi.
You can find maybe snake.
Mutapeza amina njoka.
Snake is a little bit small animal than
lion.
So when you come to find out what white, how many people have been killed with a snake, you may find maybe 3,000. Hallelujah. Then maybe you come to a little thing. Maybe you come to the mosquito. How many do you know mosquito? Hallelujah. And then you take a statistic. How many have been killed with a mosquito? You may find 10 million. Hallelujah. And then you come to the virus.
Which
we cannot see by our eyes. Hallelujah. Oh, bacteria. And when you take the statistic,
worldwide,
how many people have been killed with this virus? Oh, bacteria. You will find maybe more than 20 million. Hallelujah. So remember, it's not a big sin that you think it will send you to hell. But it is a small thing that is an independent sin that will send you to hell. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Yes.
There was a story. Some women, those who said they went to heaven,
and
heaven also. But that is a story. So it was somewhere, made a sense somewhere. And then the one who went there, he found a woman there. That woman, he was lived a faithful life. So when he died, you see, everybody believed that this woman is Jesus in heaven. And this one, he find her in there. In hell. Says, Mama, why you are here? You are
here.
Which one brought you here? And then
she
says, one day, I went to my neighbor just to ask a match. So when I was returning to her, I just took two sticks. without telling my name, that I just took the two sticks. That's the thing which brought me here.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Even if she could tell her neighbor that I took, there's no problem. It seems there's no problem. But before God, last week, I was a pastor from Durban. I believe some of you know him, Pastor Chris Naido. Hallelujah. So he was giving us a testimony that his wife one day, she found there was no peace at all. And then he said, Lord, what did I commit to you?
What did I do?
I have no peace. And then Lord told him, so that is the sister, a wife for it. The wife of pastor. And so when the pastor was in the prayer room, and he find that they don't have a blade, and then he went, he took a wallet of his husband, he took some amount there, and he went to buy a bed for the family. And then Holy Ghost told him, who allowed you to take the money from the wallet of my servant? Without the permission. But the money was for the family use. Who can think about that?
Yeah.
Who can think about that?
Yeah.
Even if pastor comes,
yeah.
But Holy Ghost was not happy with that one. You see?
Yeah.
So don't despise the small thing. Hallelujah. You need to be clean into your heart. Hallelujah. Amen. Listen close. In the message God provided way, listen, it is not necessary that any man would go to hell. And God doesn't send no one to hell. You send yourself to hell. God done everything in the world he can to keep you from going to hell. And yet he determined to go to hell. You fight over every bucket God puts in your way. You just go light on over it. Hallelujah. You know for what? A repented
thing.
Those drivers,
my driver,
you find in the highway, there is some humps. You see?
Yeah, man.
That's telling you, reduce your speed.
Hallelujah.
Yeah,
man.
Somewhere you find there's a wall. They can put electricity. Years back in back home there, we used to put above the wall, you put some, you just cut some glasses, you put there.
Hallelujah.
But maybe, I want you to assume.
But we are not even
organized. As the
brother
said, God is trying to make any bucket. Bucket, I don't know how to speak. Something that is hinder you.
Oh, I'm going to put a bucket in the jacket. You take it to your chin, I'm going to go one.
So when you get there, as you said, you determine to go to hell. Hallelujah. Have you seen? You find you are somewhere. Where is God? Is he here? Tell you that don't go there. And the devil is here. He says, you come here. And then the brother says, all we see is sweet. Hallelujah. So in order to see, you need to reject the good word of God there. You
said
no. You stay there. Let me commit it. First, we will meet later. That is what we did every day. Hallelujah. Amen. In the message, Jesus of
Nazareth
passes by.
Paragraph 42.
Listen carefully. Hallelujah. So please don't hate me. Hallelujah. This is your prophet. Is he just reminding you? And me. That we never miss heaven. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then if you span mess, only one thing left. That is judgment. If we learn a little light and get hit, don't blame the city. You should have stopped. If you wind up in hell someday, don't blame God. He waved every across the front of you that he can wave. One day, this in the highway, and there is a car going this side. Another one was coming this side. So the one who is going, maybe to say, let's say in the long way, he comes from this man in
Kasungu.
And when he meet with this one, he waved. Don't care
there.
And they said, don't care yourself. Hallelujah. But this one was warning him. There is a lot of dog in the way, so take care. And this one, he just repeated, don't care yourself. Maybe he was just abusing him. And within a short time, he hit those donkeys. His car and him dead there.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Listen here.
Yes, sir. I need to hear.
If you wind up in hell someday, don't blame God.
Musade Mungu
ai. He wept everything across the front of you. That he can
wep.
Even the blood of his only holy son.
Nakare makazi amana wake era yokao.
And you have constantly wept light on by.
Ndiye iwe wabweleza somango pondereza mumachimene ocho.
The songs of church,
nyimbo za mchanishi,
the preaching of the gospel, the leading of the word, sign and wonders before you, and still blinded, just determined to go whether God stopped or not.
Pamene Mungu wangu uyo wangu tsindikiza kuti usipitirirabe pamene Mungu akuza kuti uyime.
God don't send nobody to hell.
Mungu satu ni samina aliyese kuhadi.
You send yourself to hell by injecting his
Mungu atitumisa weka kukahena pakukana mwana wake ubameka.
Yes, sir. Richard.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Rejecting his son.
Kukana mwana wake ikai.
Means rejecting his weight.
Unaweza kukana maula yake.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why Brother Branham says.
Nilifanya mbele mwana mlinda kuti.
You have nobody to blame it.
Palibe wina mimi ngamudeso ai.
Sister can come to you.
Yo mate kubera kwai.
Sister, this attitude you are going through.
Mwango kadira mimi ngudu samo ini.
It is against with the word.
Not
you are just ashamed the message of the hour. And then she will say, leave me alone. You see? A brother can come to you. Brother.
Mbali.
I hear that you are doing something. There is a bad rumor about you in the street.
Bali mpengeserayoi pawekuta inu muzinda uno.
So please, if there is something,
ndiyo jone kariwa shina jake.
Stop it.
Siya.
I will pray for you.
Ndiku mpengere.
And then say, mind your own business.
Ya, iwe chita zako, zimeno funa ma. Kachita zako.
That is the waving of the Holy Ghost. And then you despise
this.
You know, when you are saving, when we say this man is sent, this sister is sent, means the way you are saving people around you. Likewise, when this is not sent, it's the same the way you are saving people around you. Hallelujah. So, God is a man.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
There was a sister. It was the same thing like this one. Hallelujah. And then,
the
Holy Ghost came to a certain sister. And said,
Nati,
you play for that sister. So when the old church was get out, the sister remained to play for that sister. When this sister came out, he went to another sister. He said, you know some sisters, we all the church get out. And she shows herself that she is better than all others.
Yes.
And this sister said, how can you say something like that? So when that sister was playing for her, and her was abusing her, that's why she remained there in the church, while the others were out. And then this another...
Yes, sister, you... pamene anali kumpempherera anali kunyoza nsisa amene akumpemphererayo kunena kuti achifukwa chana kuchita zinthu izi pamene chichose chaturuka iye kumabwera kumadzandipempherera ine akufuna zitionetsa kuti iye ndi ndani.
Hallelujah. And then this sister said, how can you say something evil like that?
Ndiye mulungu wina yamudzudzula iwe unganene bwanji chinthu choyipa ngati chonchi.
When that sister came out, please go and approach.
But
at the same time, the Holy Ghost came to the sister, stopped to play because that sister has already passed the line. And then sister is coming. Sister, sorry, you know, I talked bad thing to you, so forgive me. And then this sister replied, no problem, but God told me I was praying for you. God told me to stop because you have already closed the line.
I said,
me? No. No, sister, don't argue.
Yeah, I will go sit in Uganda.
God bless you.
Mumbabulani said.
After 1 month,
but I'm going to tell you,
she was a prostitute in the street.
I have a lady who will have a sin.
Hallelujah. So when somebody comes to warn you something, that is God. Don't hate her. Don't speak bad. Hallelujah. You just say, sister, brother, pray for me. Pray for me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Are you tired?
Are you tired?
Are you tired? Amen. In the message, what went ye out to see?
Montenda, wamri numuna tuluga bukaona shiani.
Paragraph
61.
Jesus 61.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You can't help being what you are.
Yes.
Even if you are a sinner,
yes,
you are not responsible for being a sinner. You are responsible for remaining a sinner. There is a way prepared for you, but to be a sinner, you was born that way. Hallelujah. God doesn't send you to hell for being a sinner. God sends you to hell because you won't repent. And take Christ as your Savior. You refuse to take the light load. Hallelujah. You send yourself to torment. You send your own soul to eat its eternal destruction. Upon the free moral agents of your own conviction. God doesn't send anyone to hell.
Mungu sana misaenda aliyese kukahena.
He never did it.
Sada shite epo.
And he never will.
Ndiwa sasa shite epo.
Men sent themselves to hell.
Antu wana chitumisa oka kukahena.
Because they refuse to accept the way of salvation.
Chifungwa iwo akana kutenda njira yetu kumutu.
God isn't, he is long suffering.
Mungu ndiwa pilila kwa kwa nina.
He doesn't want anyone to perish.
Safu na ina yesa taingi.
Never wanted it.
Safu na pangu na gulu.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So,
dear
God, you are going to have nothing to blame. Especially we believers. We know many things. We know great revelation. We know how very well how to go through. But we refuse it. So our judgment will be greater than all denominations. Because we know better how to go. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes, Father Lord.
Hallelujah. God help us.
Mulunga litandizi.
Hide not your sin, remember.
Musadise chimolano kumbugirani.
Say upon me. After me.
Nenani.
Hide not your sin.
Nenani mwani tsadila hile. Musadise chimolano.
Hallelujah. Those who cover their sin will not prosper.
You know, brother,
sister, maybe you have been fighting for a long time. You are suffering for a long time. Hallelujah. But you don't accept that you commit a sin somewhere. And you are supposed to repent. You don't want to repent. The day you repent, everything will be over. Everything will be over.
Amen.
Because you cannot pass the word of God that if you cover your sin, you will not and you will never prosper.
Hallelujah.
So you just find a time. Explore your life. Just find enough time. Separate yourself.
As
a father.
And you babo,
of a mother,
and you marry,
if a boy or
girl, and you sigana,
find out.
Fufuza.
Why? Since I have been the message.
Tufuza, the men in that carina will turn down.
Since I will not go the way I want.
See, to see, we will end up with a medicine as you see a day.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. Just ask the Lord. Lord, show me. I am led to repent. If there is a hidden sin, I am led to repent. Please reveal to me where I did mistake. Hallelujah. Tell him. By any cost, I'm going to make right. You know, Brother Brand says, even if the sin is going to skin you are supposed to repent.
Yeah.
Brother,
you
come.
For example,
my sons,
maybe you have sinned.
When I'm a shima,
maybe at that time,
when is a guru,
and you have been hiding.
Jama Kalamu, which you said,
and then,
Jetsono,
Holy Ghost come.
Mzima ya kwera.
That when you go to the pulpit,
would you have never gone
before all people?
Panaso van words.
And you repent it.
What happened?
I will forgive you.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
And the other option,
yes,
is that you remain quiet,
yes,
with your thing,
yes,
and you don't know whether God has forgiven you or not.
Yes.
Which is better?
Yes.
To get ashamed before people,
yes,
but to be right with God. Or to remain quiet. And you don't know if God has forgiven
you.
Which way will you choose?
Yes.
He's saying it is better to be ashamed on the face of the people than to be ashamed before God.
Amen. You see? So when you reach at that point, you have got a victory.
Amen.
We are ashamed before people. Whom most of them are going to hell.
Yes. Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Let me tell you something. When you take action, that God, I'm going to repent. No matter what. No matter how people will say it. But if I'm going to be right with my Lord, if my Lord is going to receive my repentance,
that
will suffice everything.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You know the goodness of God. When you take that action, you will find those people, instead of laughing at you, they just praise you. God can able to cover it. Instead of being ashamed, people can see that you are here. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So don't accept the advice of demons. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You see, sometimes in the family,
yes.
You find a brother is misbehaving. Hallelujah.
Yes.
When he comes to church, he may be a deacon. He may be any post pastor or what. People can be say, ah, this man of God. When he is here, he can be say, amen, hallelujah.
Amen, hallelujah.
Crying. Repenting him. And everybody can put a trust on him. But when you come to his family, he's torturing his wife. His family, his children are not here. And then he calls a wife. His wife. He has got a lot of pain in his heart.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
He just get a lot of burdens.
How is Osama Nyamula Kadunu Otobo Tawalembera Mutuno?
When she came here,
Jaga Maraguno,
she cannot worship God.
Sanga Tegu Pendoza Murugwa.
Because
Kifuga,
his husband, her husband.
Namuna Wageyu.
You see?
Yes.
And remember,
Jaga Mugira,
you are Lapcha.
Ukwaturo wanu
starting from your wife.
Umeambia kwa mkazi wanu
starting from your family.
Umeambia baba njema.
Never let an arrogant spirit ever come around you.
Usiwe mzimu wangu anayekumbele kuzungulia hivi.
Don't let no malice come in.
Usiwe sanje mwele kati mwangu.
No matter what anybody has done. If they are wrong, don't you never build up a complex against that
person.
See?
Yes.
You be free. And kind. Remember. God loved you when you were in sin. And if the Spirit of God is in you, you love the other person. When he's wrong, see? Just play for them and love one another. Above everything, love God. Love one another. And be humble.
Please
God. And
a
loved one. Another. God will bless us. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
So somebody can be asking, what aim should I do? So what should I do?
Amen.
I have been covered my sin for a long time. I have a lot of unrepented sins. What should I do? Where should I start? Hallelujah.
Yeah.
You know, there is some sin you committed to a man. Oh, a sister. Some you committed direct to God.
Hallelujah.
So if you committed to man, don't go direct to God.
Amen.
You sinned for God. You
sinned
for this man. You
sinned
for this sister. So get courage. Pray for God that now I take his step. I want to make right. Hallelujah. There is that. Do not hesitate to take action. Hallelujah. Sometimes you know what I did. It is too hard. Hallelujah. Find your pastor. Take him. Confess. And he will pray with you. Don't hide from pastor. You know?
When?
You know God is not an old man. God is not a grandfather. That you can hide, you can try to.
You
God is very wise.
Yes.
He knows if you mean it. Oh, if you are just praying, but you take it serious. If you have something that is hanging, please make it. You know we have no time. Those who are just throwing the news, we have no time. If you fall in the Middle East there, our time peace is Israel. Hallelujah. Isaiah 1. That is the last scripture.
Isaiah 1.
I close.
Do you check us, Sovano? Let's check up. Do you have the series? Isaiah 1.
Amen.
Amen.
Are you okay?
What is your name?
Amen.
Are you still love me?
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
God bless you.
Amen.
Isaiah 1.
Yes, Isaiah 1.
This is the answer from God himself. Advising you what you should take
action.
Wash yourself. Verse 16. Wash yourself.
Somebody knock.
Make yourself clean.
Jealousy knock.
Hallelujah. Say amen.
Amen.
I want to hear amen from you because this is the solution God is giving you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Wash yourself.
Somebody knock.
Amen. Make yourself clean.
Jealousy knock.
Amen.
Put away the evil of your doings from before my eyes.
Hallelujah.
Cease to do evils.
Amen.
That is not me. That is the Bible. That is God.
You see, then you are going to be
learn to do good.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Seek justice. Rebuke the oppressor.
Defend
the fatherless. Plead for the widows. Hallelujah. Yes. Now he is inviting you. Come now.
Come now.
We are
Sovan.
Who are ready to come to accept the invitation of the Lord? Hallelujah. Lord Jesus is telling you, come. And let us live together. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Though you are thin, I like scarlet. They shall be as white as snow. Though they are laid like
Gibson,
they shall be as if you are willing and obedient, you shall eat the good of the land. Hallelujah. Come, let me go together. Is it
that
a good God?
God,
I need
to see my God.
Hallelujah.
Is that a good God?
God, I need to see my God.
Yes.
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 My son.
My daughter.
My daughter.
My daughter. Yes.
Come.
Yeah.
Sit there.
Kalaba.
Sit there.
Kalaba.
Yes. Let's reason together.
Get in and be
hallelujah.
Yes. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tell me.
Mdumusi.
What is your problem?
You don't have a design.
You are not the same.
Usu no mbondo.
I saved you.
No one will attack you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I am here for you.
Ine nini ma mfanya you.
Why are you suffering?
Why are you mfutika?
How? Why are you crying?
Why are you mfutika?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then, because he invited you to speak out. Let's listen together. Hallelujah. But we always learn.
Yes.
You know, you can get into your safe room.
mutagulowa mushipinda chanu chanoka.
Still, you fear to speak with your God.
Koma mkubale pera kubayamfula naye Mungu wangu. Mushipinda mwano kamo.
Yes.
Whom you don't even see.
Amini simbuna mkomo.
And you learn.
Matao.
Since he invited you, come and reason together. You speak out.
My dad.
My
dad.
This is it. I failed to get out. Can you help me?
Yes.
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 Amen.
Yes.
Yes.
This is character. I don't like it.
Sing you go on
die. Always just following me.
Tari says in mango di
chance is like on me.
Ni mango sunguri ya ine.
I don't like it.
Sing you funa.
Can you help me?
Muga ni tandi ise.
I want me and you to be friends.
Ufuna ine di ilu de kareba ubari.
Yeah.
Amen. You see?
Gwena.
See father.
Mune na ataji.
I have been poor for a long time.
Na kareba sawa ukadini kwa tayo utani.
No.
My children.
We don't eat a good food. We don't have the clothes.
So far as
I need to get out of this.
He
said, okay. It is simple, get it. There is a sister, sorry. Just this one as example. Then in the city in Tanzania, don't always make your God that is your enemy or it is somebody else. Make a God like a friend. Don't always go to God, you are crying. Forgive me. Evening, forgive me. Tomorrow morning, forgive me. Always you are just repenting, repenting, repent. Always you are like on your place, repenting.
Musabango wera mamungwa, ndaliso sabiri kurugeri, mawa biri kurugeri, mazura biri kurugeri, masana biri kurugeri. Tema bembele wano, ndaliso sumambo, lapa biri kurugeri kurugeri.
Yes!
Kura chani?
And since God said, you are my friend. So sometimes approach God as your friend.
Amen.
That is a sister in Tanzania.
Say
God, today. I ate. It is a long time since I ate meat.
Inetu ligari
yes, sir.
Can you supply meat for? I have got no money. Was passing in the road. Then the truck hit it. And then the animal was
going.
Before the house of the sister. And then the sister took the knife. And then, thank you God, you are out of my
Hallelujah.
There's a plug in Zimbabwe. Said Lord. We ate fish for a long time. And today we eat a fish. Can you provide us a fish? Hallelujah. And then God sent an eagle. Go to the Victoria Falls there. And then he got a big fish. And the eagle came to drop in front of the house of the plant. The